again. Now here's a little sketch by two boys from London town. They've been writing for 3 years and they've come up with a little number. Here it is. It's called Restaurant Sketch.
It's nice here, isn't it?
Oh, very good restaurant. 3 stars, you know.
Really? Mm.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madame.
Good evening.
And may I say what a pleasure it is to see you here again, sir.
Oh, thank you. Well, there you are, dear. Let's have a look there. Anything you like? The Buffon Croûte is fantastic. Oh,
if I may suggest, sir, the Pheasant à la Reine. The sauce is one of the chef's most famous creations.
Mm. That sounds good. Anyway, just have a look. Take your time. What you like. Oh, by the way, got a bit of a dirty fork. Could you get me another one?
A bigger bottle?
Well, something. I've got a fork, a little bit dirty. Could you get me another one? Thank you.
Oh, sir, I do apologise.
Oh, no need to apologise. Doesn't worry me.
Oh, no. I do apologise. I will fetch the head waiter immediately.
Oh, there's no need to do that.
Oh, no. I'm sure the head waiter, he will want to apologise to you himself. I will fetch him at once.
Well, you certainly get good service.
They really look after you, yes.
Excuse me, sir, madam.
Stuffy! Gaston! Find out who washed this up and give them their cards immediately!
No.
Better still, can't afford to take any chances. Sack the entire washing up staff!
No, I don't want to make any trouble.
Oh, no, please, it's no trouble. It's quite right that you should point these kind of things out.
Gaston! Tell the manager what has happened immediately!
Please, I don't want to cause any fuss.
Please, it's no fuss. We simply wish to ensure that nothing interferes with your complete enjoyment of the meal.
I'm sure it won't. It was only a dirty fork.
I know. And I'm sorry.
Bitterly sorry. But I know that no apologies I can make can alter the fact that in our restaurant you have been given a dirty, filthy, smelly piece of cutlery.
What, smelly?
It was smelly and obscene and disgusting. And I hate it. Nasty, grubby, dirty, mangy, scrubby little bog.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madam. I'm the manager. I've only just heard. And may I sit down?
Yes, of course.
I want to apologise humbly, deeply, and sincerely about the fork.
Oh, no, please. I was only a tiny bit dirty. I just couldn't see it.
Oh, you're good, kind, fine people for saying that. But I can see it. To me, it's like a mountain. A vast bowl of pus. It gets me here. I can't give you any excuses for it. There are no excuses. I've been meaning to spend more time in the restaurant recently, but I haven't been too well, and things aren't going very well back there. The poor cook's son has been put away again, and poor old Mrs. Dalrymple, who does the washing up, can hardly move her poor fingers. And then there's Gilberto's war wound. But they're good people. And they're kind people. Together, we were beginning to get over this dark patch. There was light at the end of the tunnel. When this happened!
Could I get you some water?
It's the end of the road!
Look what you've done to him! He's worked his fingers to the bone to make this place what it is! And you come in with your petty Seymour quibbling! And you grind him into the dirt! This fine, honourable man whose boots you are not worthy to kiss! Oh, it makes me mad!
Easy, Mungo. Easy. Mungo.
What?
The war wound.
The wound. It's the end.
Oh, they destroyed him.
The end. Oh,
he's dead.
They killed him. Revenge.
No, Mungo. Never kill a customer.
Not
lucky we didn't say anything about the dirty knife. No.
Well, there we are then. That was restaurant sketch. Nice little number. A bit vicious in parts, but a lot of fun. But how about that punchline, eh? Oh, well, you know what I mean. Oh, really?